Okay, no fancy intro. We're just going right into it. Good to see you guys. Thanks for hanging out with me, whether you're watching on YouTube or on Twitch. I'm glad you found me today. We're here. It's just me, but we are going to be hanging out doing a little bit of chit-chatting today. We're going to let some folks pop in, but we got a lot to talk about as things have been busy. You guys know I do a lot of stuff. And that's great. In addition to, you know, side scrollers and all the other things that we have going on, which has been really, really good. So it is me. I'm right here. And yes, I was a few minutes late. I apologize, but I'm glad to be here with you guys. So we got a lot to talk about here. We're probably going to go. No, there's no way I'm muted. No way. I'm not muted. There's no way I'm muted. Don't be like that. Don't be like that. No, I'm good. You dummy. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, we got a lot to talk about today. I and this is just going to be an open conversation today. This is a conversation between me and you and everybody else who was impacted by Screw Attack in a positive way back in the day. And I realize I'm not speaking to everybody who's a fan of side-scrollers today, and I realize we're doing this on the side-scrollers channel. But I look at side scrollers and Screw Attack as two totally different things. One, they at its core, they accomplish the same things, right? Screw Attack was the counterculture to gaming back then, and now side scrollers is the counterculture to gaming today. My career has been if you follow my career, it's very simple. I do pretty much the exact opposite of what everybody is doing at the time. And that's pretty much been my MO this entire time. But we're here and we're ready to go, and it's time to talk about this. So it's been about a month since the news about Rooster Teeth came down and the idea of their demise. And I pretty much went out there and immediately said, hey man, let's do this. Let's bring back Screw Attack. I'm ready for it. I'm ready to buy Screw Attack. At least let's start exploring it. And I've exchanged several emails, and we're at a point now where it could be a reality. And I know it's like, you know, Invader's like, do it, right? And people are like, let's do it. Okay, let's talk about the realistic nature of this and why and what could happen, and kind of my vision for if Screw Attack was to come back. And I said this a month ago, and I'll say it now, right? I don't have a whole lot of interest in bringing Screw Attack back and rebranding it or relaunching it. I do not want to do another G4, right? I don't have interest in ruining your experience with Screw Attack, right? A lot of people who watch Screw Attack back in the day, they have very fond memories of it. The team associated with it, the top 10s and the vaults and everything else associated with it. And I want to be really, really clear. I'm talking about just Screw Attack. I am not talking about Death Battle. Death Battle is being treated as its own thing. And you know what? Best of luck to those guys. I initially said I want to buy Screw Attack and Death Battle. I do, but after going back into it and really thinking about it, look, Chad and Ben, that's Ben's baby, right? Ben is the guy who walked into my office one day. He's like, I got this thing called Who Would Win? And that was the original name for Death Battle. And Ben has rode that ship literally since its inception. And like really the main contribution I had to that was naming the show, right? And that's pretty much it. Outside of that, it's been his baby primarily. Chad has played a big role in it as well. I haven't talked to those guys in a long time, but I'm sure that they are doing great. Now, I hope personally that Ben uses this opportunity to kind of spread his wings a little bit, because he's been doing Death Battle literally his entire adult life, right? And I hope that he can go on and do his own thing and create his own product that is not reliant on other people's IPs. Because I think he's super talented. He's always been talented. He was like the Wonder Kid when I hired him when he was like 16 years old, 17 years old. So let's put Death Battle to the side. Not interested in Death Battle. Let's talk about Screw Attack. I said, I don't have a whole lot of interest in restarting it and like getting a new crew and recreating, because that's like, your memories, nostalgia is a hell of a drug, and nostalgia is something that you do not want to fuck with, right? And I don't want to fuck with your nostalgia and your good memories of Screw Attack. So with that said, I think it's important to kind of talk about what my vision would be for Screw Attack if I was to buy it back, if we were to buy it back. Because if I was to buy it back, or we were to buy it back, I would have zero intention of ever selling it again. The only reason why I really want to buy it back is because all of that content is behind a pay. It's behind walls. It's not easy to find. You can't find it on YouTube. If you really search and you really dig, you can find it. It's somewhere online, but I haven't done enough research to really dig and find it. So I don't really, I can't imagine anybody who didn't own the brand would really care that much, right? So really the idea is I'd want to get it. I'd want to make that stuff available on YouTube and have its own channel for that. And that's pretty much it. Post it on YouTube, post it on TikTok, post it on Twitter, post it on Facebook, post it anywhere and everywhere that it can be posted so it can never be removed again. And I'm talking about everything, warts and all, beautiful 240p, 144p videos, all the inappropriate statements that were made and all that fun stuff that goes along with it. So yes, primarily for like archival purposes is why I would get it. And my main driving force behind this has been that my kids can't watch this. My kids, like there's a decade of, just from a personal standpoint, there is a decade of stuff that is just lost on the internet. It's just lost internet footage. But Screw Attack was a really great brand. It was a really great brand for a long time, and it was solid. And you know, some people are like, "It's gone. Just move on." And like, I agree. Like, just to be clear, I've turned the page. I've turned the page, but very rarely do you have an opportunity to regain something that was yours, right? Think about something that you loved, right? Something that you grew and you had an opportunity to get it back later on down the line. Something that has just kind of been sitting there for years and people ask you about it regularly, consistently, and tell you about the good memories that they had from it, from, you know, you doing it. And that's a really, like a really unique opportunity. So that's why it's worth exploring. So with that said, I've been on some phone calls. I've had some conversations, and without getting into crazy specifics, the asking price that they're asking for Screw Attack is six figures, which I feel is drastically overvaluing something that has not been used or even thought about, or in their mind, like, I don't even know if they even thought about it or knew that they owned it. But they're asking like six figures for this brand. And that would be, the brand, YouTube channel, social media, all the content, right? So it's a lot, right? It's a lot. And there is a 0% chance that an archive channel about of content that is from 2006 to really like 2016 would ever generate $200,000 in revenue, any sort of six figure total at all. Very, very small likelihood of that happening. And you're like, well, why would, like, the thing you need to remember is that they're asking that amount because you're talking about a company in the Warner Brother Discovery Giant Corporation, whatever they're even called now, the company that owned Rooster Teeth, and Screw Attack was under Rooster Teeth for a long, I guess till right now. You're talking about a multi-billion dollar company, and you won't even like get a turn of the head without five zeros attached to an offer. So that's kind of where we're at, right? So I have very mixed feelings about it. And I also know that nobody could or run ScrewAttack again like me. Because at the end of the day, a lot of the creative force and a lot of the ideas, a lot of people went into making ScrewAttack excellent. But at the end of the day, I was the head of the snake, right? And I was the one who made it go up until I left. And I don't think it's any coincidence that, like, after I left, Death Battle took over, and Death Battle more or less, they rebranded ScrewAttack. It was very obvious that was happening, right? And that type of content doesn't really work on the internet anymore. The short form, style content that, like, specifically like the vaults and the top tens and things like that. But like, as Starscream comes in with a massive $50 donation, says, "Craig, ScrewAttack is your content, your baby. It belongs to you. Regardless of relaunching it, I would just want it to be back where it belongs with its creator." Starscream, that's incredibly nice, man. Incredibly nice. And that's kind of the idea, is I want to bring it home, right? And by bringing it home, it means bringing it home and available to you, to those who care. And I think that realistically, it's a small number of people who really care. But I do think that I think that with ScrewAttack, I was talking to somebody about this yesterday, and they said something to me that was really profound. They were talking about media and the idea of having the opportunity. I was like, most everybody's who was a fan of ScrewAttack is they're grown up, right? And now a lot of you are watching side scrollers, which is awesome. But he said, yeah, but we also want to pass on things from our childhood and our formative years onto our kids so they can be seen, so it can be seen. It's more than a nostalgia thing. It's showing people how we got to be where we are, right? So that I heard that and I was like, wow, like that's awesome. And yeah, I mean, so there's a lot there, and you guys are coming in and you're obviously very, very passionate about the idea. And I think it's awesome. And so thank you guys very much. But I think the realistic question is, like, a month ago, I was like, I'm doing a Kickstarter, right? I'm doing a Kickstarter. I'm going to do some sort of crowdfunding thing for this. And now that we have the opportunity to do that, I want to ask you, right? Do you think it's worth doing? Because I'm certainly going to contribute money of my own to this. But I certainly can't contribute six figures to make this happen. And I think the idea behind it is, like I said, just make it available and make it available as many places as possible. And I've tinkered with the idea of once content is, my boy D-Day Cobra's in the chat, Jeremy, very nice, saying, I want Craig to own ScrewAttack again. Well, like I said, it'd be very good. It'd be very, very cool, to say the least. Jeremy, I appreciate you, buddy. And there's a lot of yeses, right? But once again, when it comes to, like, there's one thing about saying yes, and then there's another thing about, like, actually doing it. And we're talking about, like, this is not like, hey, we need like 10 grand, right? 10 grand is a lot of money, right? Let's like, we're talking that, like, that's rookie numbers in this situation. Like I said, I'm willing to contribute to this in a major way. So yes, that's kind of where we're at right now. And I think in any situation, it would be if I was to do some sort of crowdfunding, it would be a hit it or miss it type thing. And it'd be on a very specific window, because here's the thing. We are currently sitting, it's April 5th, right? If this is going to happen, it needs to be done by the end of the month, because that's the last day that a lot of people are working for this company who can make these deals happen, right? After that, it goes into the dustbin and maybe the trash bin, and that stuff never seen again. So that's kind of where we're at. So we are on a timetable, and it is a lot of money. The other side of this is that I have a lot going on a day-to-day basis. Between side scrollers, and just 2 weeks ago, I mean, you guys know, if you have been following, I announced Take Games Back, which has been spectacular. People are very interested in this. And I will have a lot of news about that. I've been working my ass off on this behind the scenes. If I have not been streaming, I've been doing this. And a lot more information will come from this in the next couple weeks. So with Take Games Back, that's a huge thing. It's going to take up a lot of time. I didn't even get a chance to talk about, like, and I've been working on this even longer, a supplement brand that I'm launching that is designed around the idea. It's called Blue Bonnet Supplements, and it's all built around like yummy gummies and stuff. And they're awesome. I've been working on that since the third quarter of last year, right? Getting everything right. I didn't even had a chance. So the point is that there's a lot going on, right? And I want to make sure that if we do this, that ultimately the proper time, energy, and resources are given to it. And because otherwise it's not fair to you, and it's not fair to me, and it's not fair to Screw Attack, and it's not fair to anybody else who may want to watch that content later on down the line, because it does take time, man. So yeah, I mean, it's a lot. So, you know, I think I'll look over to you guys now, and I'll kind of open it. There's a lot of super chats that have come in, and I appreciate that. And I'll answer some of your questions. So I let's just start there. Number one. And okay. And here's the other thing, right? I like launching any sort of Kickstarter or crowdfunding. I've done that once. Well, outside of Screw Attack, like at Screw Attack, we launched one for SGC 1 year, and we asked for 120K, and that took over a month to get. I think right on a month. I think we hit it on the last day, and going into the last day, we were only like halfway there, and we had this like ridiculous Hail Mary at the end, and we ended up getting there, and that brought SGC back after a 2 year hiatus. And then I did a kind of a crowdfunding for a project I was kicking off called Collaborator Club about four or five years ago, maybe. I don't even know. It may have been shorter than that. But and that was where you actually had the opportunity to have ownership in that brand, right? And that brand and that opportunity got shelved because of an opportunity that came to me to pretty much leave the industry as a whole. And it was too good of an opportunity. I had to take it. So everybody got their money back there and everything. But that was really, really cool. I don't think we could do something like that in this situation where you guys own a piece of Screw Attack, because simply from a timeline perspective of this, the timeline perspective of this is very tight, and getting one of those crowdfunding campaigns that where you actually own, at least from my memory, I'm talking up memory here. It took like almost 3 weeks to get that set up before it could be launched, because there's like a vetting process and stuff. And I don't think we have the time to do that in this situation. So, but I think in a situation, I think it'd be really, really, really cool if you guys had the opportunity to own a piece of it. But I don't think we have the timing won't work out to run a campaign like that. But Curtis says, so you're thinking Screw Attack will mostly be in for archival purposes. I think yes, primarily. Now, with that said, I do not want to relaunch the brand. Like I said, I've said this before. I don't want to relaunch it. I don't want to be like, hey, here's a new G4, and then like ruin your childhood. Although I would be open to creating new vaults and top tens. I would be open to doing that. But once again, it goes back to, I got side scrollers and Take Games Back and Blue Bonnet. And it just comes down to like, at a certain point, you run out of like our most precious resource of time. And I want to make sure that if I do this, I have time to treat it properly. Thanks, Curtis. Appreciate that. Yankee Lover says, Screw Attack made me feel like being a gamer is okay. Thank you for you and your team, Craig. Without y'all and others, I would have felt shunned. Thank you, Yankee Lover. Appreciate that, man. Let's see. D. Roy says, I remember the first time I found Screw Attack through watching AVG, and I missed the intro of Top 10s. I'm Stuttering Craig and Handsome Tom, right? Thanks, D-Roy. Appreciate that. Handsome Tom came in with a $2 donation. It says, Where's all the money you got from when you first sold ScrewAttack? And why do we have to pay to fix, quote unquote, your mistakes? What is stopping you from selling again? Well, fake handsome Tom, the money that I got when I sold ScrewAttack has gone into my life and gone into properties and investments and launching other brands and opportunities. So that's what I've done with my money. Now, with that said, I did say that I will be contributing a nice chunk of money that I can afford and will afford to go to this. And you don't have to do anything. Nobody's forcing you to do anything. And what's stopping me from selling again? Me telling you it's not going to happen. And there's not really a product to be sold. You know, that's the thing. Fake handsome Tom. And nice job. Good try. Parallelogram, Joseph says, it's just a name. You got this far with that loser DSP. You and your team is what's important. Everything else is bells and whistles. You make it your own value. I don't see side scrollers. I see Craig or Melanie. Thanks. Appreciate that. There's truth in that, right? In a brand like this, like side scrollers, like ScrewAttack, like Mega 64, or pick any other gaming brand. It really comes down to the personalities, and personalities are what makes that brand for sure. GraphWeb says, don't G4. Now that's the last thing I want to do. Curtis says, if you can't get them under 150K, even if you don't buy it, you would have to do more with it to get proper return. Ad revenue won't do it alone. 100%. Yeah, 100%. Mercenary says, here's $5 for me to help fund this, whatever it takes to get our culture back. We will not go quietly in the night. We can't lose history or else. Right. And that's another big part of it. I think that, you know, ScrewAttack was a giant part of video game culture from early 2010s and late 2000s, a big part of that. And, that's just kind of gone now, and it will never come back. And I think that's actually a really, really big part of this. And I appreciate you putting it in there. Joseph says, you're trading money for nothing. Does an actor own the movies they're in? No, but they do get pieces of the residuals, though, occasionally, if you're good enough. Becky Ricardo says, Craig, all I want is when I tell someone about your epic taco rant to be able to quickly look it up on YouTube and show them. Thanks, Backyard Dartist. Appreciate that. That's all I want. All I want. Curtis says, just my opinion, under 150K for the price or no go. Thanks, Curtis. EJ Paladin says, is a member. Thank you very much for 1 month. And Wheeling Through Life with Brian, my boy, says, let's crowdfund or kickstart so future generations can watch ScrewAttack. It's your baby. Well, thanks, brother. I appreciate that. That's massive and huge and greatly appreciated. It would be a very big undertaking, to say the least. It would be a very big undertaking to make it happen. With that said, I thought it'd be fun. You know, I mentioned like vaults and top tens and even, like, if I was to come back and do some stuff a la ScrewAttack, it would be like those old video game vaults and top tens. So a lot of people are like, what are you talking about? Well, let me kind of show you an example of what like a video game vault was back in the day, if you haven't seen these. So I want to let you know, here's the thing about this. I actually do have most of the content for ScrewAttack available already. I have it on a hard drive, which was sent to me by a fan a few years ago. And I appreciate that fan several years back. So I thought it'd be fun to kind of just jog down memory lane here and kind of watch this and this kind of like the type of stuff that I would probably do possibly, maybe if ScrewAttack was to come back. I think that, you know, side scrollers would certainly be its own thing, and ScrewAttack would be more like the, like, I see side scrollers as like, we talk about the news, we talk about the culture aspect of video games. And like, that's what side scrollers is. And as far as like ScrewAttack could be like the video game side of it, where they would talk about the actual games themselves. So here you go. This is like an example. This is a video game vault of Mega Man 3, I think, back in the day. How great would it be to have that back, huh?
No matter where 3 ranks on your list of Mega Man games, it was definitely a turning point in the series. 3 new Mega Man staples were introduced here: the Slide, Rush the Dog, and a mysterious new character, Proto Man. Let's start with the Slide. No longer was Mega Man just a run and jump guy, the Slide gave him the ability to dodge enemy attacks, as well as reach new places. Pretty rad. Next is Rush, your robotical canine buddy. Just like in Mega Man 2 with the extra add-ons, there were different abilities you can gain for Rush. Personally, I always thought Rush was kind of a beating, but he helps you out, so it's cool. Finally, we have arguably the most important addition, Proto Man. This may sound stupid, but I remember the first time I heard his intro. I thought it was so cool, and then BAM! You gotta fight him! What the crap? What a nice introduction. While you played through Mega Man 3, you actually had to fight him 4 separate times, and the entire time you're like, what the hell is up with this guy? Sure, he's got the most predictable fighting pattern in video game history, but damn, he's annoying. So after you fight this dude and the other 8 master robots, you think you're ready for Dr. Wily's castle, right? Nope. You gotta redo some levels and fight all 8 robots from Mega Man 2. Damn! This game is full of twists, but that's what made it great. You had the highs and the lows without a lot of story. So you finally get to Dr. Wily's castle and beat down everyone in your way and finally beat Dr. Wily. Wait. Ugh, another skull? Damn it, anyhow. Alright, so you finally defeat the real Dr. Wily with what might be the worst and most useless power-up in video game history, the Top Spin. And out of nowhere, that bastard Proto Man comes and saves you. The drama. Yet another twist. Turns out Proto Man is actually your brother and he sacrificed himself for you. What a guy. But now he lives in the clouds. Until Capcom needs him for the next game. With its twists, turns, innovations, and 8-bit drama, Mega Man 3 is one of the best games of its generation. It's a shame that after 3, it all started to go downhill.
All right. Which was a stupid statement, by the way, because it was those last few games were great. That's whenever I look at those videos like that, by the way, this is the actual, that was a full size version of that. That video itself looks like this in reality. It's a tiny little video. I think 360p was our delivery, maybe 480. And that's the thing is like, these videos are low quality, like physical low quality. These are not 1080p. And I have zero interest in like restoring them, right? You notice the footage was grainy. Like I just want to put it out there, you know? And I think that'd be really fun. And I think it'd be fun to release a new video every day, just like we did back at Screw Attack when that was our original tagline. So like, that's the type of video that I'd like to do. Like video game vaults, I always considered them, oh yeah. Like they're, oh yeah, videos. You watch them and you go, oh yeah, I remember that game. And that's like, they're anywhere between 90 seconds and 3 minutes. And those would be great on TikTok. Don't you think those would be great at like TikTok or Twitter or, you know, and that's the other thing about this is I'm talking about pushing this out everywhere, right? There's no, like YouTube is obviously a great place to be, but I want it to be literally everywhere. And in addition to like, you know, the video game vaults and the top tens, you know, there's also all the old clip of the weeks and all the eating competitions and stuff that I would love to put up as well. So John says, tell us the price. Yeah. So that's kind of what we're talking about here, right? Without getting into specifics, and I don't want to get into specifics because I don't want somebody to be very clear. I don't want anybody just like to swoop in, right? To be clear, but even if they did, like, what are they buying? You know? But we're talking, this is a 6-figure price is what they're asking for this. So that's kind of where we're at. Commander Kronk says, here's $5 now and I'll donate $20 to the Kickstarter. I want to show my child the fun I grew up with when she gets old enough. I appreciate that. That's awesome. Andrew says, it's like trying to regain custody of a kid. Nice. Cesario says, and here's me chipping in the pot chum. Go get it. I get dibs on job as a community manager. Promise not to get shamed by grums from malicious incompetence. Thanks, Cesario. Appreciate that. Maple came in with a massive $20. That's awesome. So say, Craig, if you buy Screw Attack again, maybe you can pass that torch on to upcoming creators that could carry it for you while you're working on other projects. Yeah, I think it would need to be the right person for sure. But that's actually a really, really great idea because I'm sure people could. Like, the thing about it, when these videos were made, and we're talking about games on the NES, Super Nintendo, 64. That time period from when those videos were made to the time of those games release is the same period of right now to like when the Wii was released, to put that in perspective. So like we could be literally be doing vaults on Wii games. Oh, it'd be crazy. But it would need like, I would need somebody who can do it in that fun voice, you know, but at the same time, like I said, I'm not really interested in like building out a team. You know, I'm really not. Nikki says it's been 11 months since I've become a member. And how much are they asking for Screw Attack? You know, like I said, they're asking six figures for that. Jeff says, is it all digital? Are there physical assets? Pretty much just all digital. Yeah, pretty much all digital. No physical assets that I can think of. But obviously, we would eventually get to something like, merchandise, shirts, things like that. Because I think that would be pretty cool, like an old school Screw Attack, like distressed logo shirt and things like that. Chris says, were I in your shoes, I'd reach out to Elon to help in the purchase, make it X exclusive for a limited window of time, but you own the full archives. I don't think Elon has a whole lot of interest in Screw Attack, but I'll ask. KK Man says, you deserve to own it, and I hope you can. At the same time, Screw Attack is only one of many things you did to make the gaming industry better. And you continue to 20 years later. You have my support all the way. Okay, thank you very much. That's really nice. Hal came in and says, just get the money for shilling the Amico. Duh, that's right. That's right. Big old shill. Curtis says, AI upscaling maybe? I don't know. Like I said, I think I like the idea of just glorious 144 280p, you know? Yeah. Chike Tomate says, dang, that intro goes hard. Oh, the memories. Thanks, man. Well, I got another one pulled up for you guys as well. Noodle says, for Screw Attack, definitely want you to have what's yours. Plus, miss the vaults in the top 10s. Well, I got a top 10 to show you guys in a second as well. Bob came in and says, member berries are yum, but if it doesn't make financial sense, then it's not worth the drop. If they destroy it, you can take it back for free. There is truth in that. Yeah. Nezinik says, what about doing like a donation-a-thon? Yeah, there would definitely be some sort of crowdfunding thing. Like I said, I'm more than willing to donate, and when I say donate, I mean put in five figures into making this happen. So Steven says, are you a fan of emulation? It seems like are selling off their collections and just emulating. Any thoughts? Oh, you're talking about emulation of video games. Yeah, that's happening all the time. I don't blame people, to be totally honest with you. I played Donkey Kong Country 2 via emulation recently. It's great. Denny says, FYI, Craig Reddit does not want you to buy back Screw Attack. After all, you're alt-right. Congrats. Well, hello, Reddit. Good to see you. Sorry. Nowhere Dude says, Super Screw Attack or Screw Attack Next Gen. John says, the glory days. Take us back, Craig. Thank you, John. Appreciate that. Carpet University says, if this happens, will you also include the old hard news videos? Ooh, I got to be honest. And I don't know if they exist. I think some of them do, but most of them, they just got put off and deleted after a while, which was very poor archiving. But it would be fun to see like the old hard news. I know there were special ones that were saved, but like just the day-to-day, I think were removed. So thanks, Carpet. Nezinik says, everyone should directly donate when possible. Oh, not super chat. Yeah, this is true. And thanks for your super chat. Todd came in and says, for the Screw Attack Fund, found y'all through AVGM back in the day. Yeah. James was huge for the exposure of Screw Attack. Evan says, for us, Screw Attack is worth millions, but for them, it's not worth anything. Screw Attack has no value to them, and six figures is insane. But I want it back in the hands of the stuttering one and the G2s. And man, I miss them top 10s. Well, we'll get to one of those in just a second. Thanks, Evan. Appreciate that, man. I will say this, man. It is like it's very cool to see the response to this idea. Like I said, I don't have any interest. If we were to get it back, it would need to be swift and it would need to be quick. And, but it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. So it would need to be done like very, very quick. So, and like I said, I'm definitely going to be contributing to it. So Hal says, would they lower the price if you were trans? I don't know. Lance came in and says, I sadly didn't grow up with Screw Attack. Didn't even discover Rooster Teeth until 2011 or 2012, but I'd still love to see this happen. Let this part of internet history stay alive. Thanks, Lance Corporal Hawk. Roddy says, it belongs back in your hands, Craig. Go get it. Thanks, brother. Dev came in and says, I want my $5 to specifically go towards restoration of the behind-the-scenes video of you as the ghost of Christmas past. That's awesome. That's awesome. That is great. Josh316 says, Screw Attack was a staple for my teenage years. I got into so many arguments over every episode. I never hated and loved to show, much like Screw Attack. Josh, that is massive. A $100 super chat. Thank you very much for that support. And I'm glad we could create such a divisive experience for you. That's awesome. Colorama says, what the hell is Screw Attack? That's right, Colorama. Shane O'Mac came in and says, 24-hour fundraising stream with Blabs and all the friends. I pitch in to watch all day. Here's the thing. I think this is outside of side scrollers. Like, I would not get Blabs associated with it. I think this is just me, you know? And people are like, well, why don't you reach out to other people? Like, I mean, I could. They probably wouldn't want to be. Honestly, they probably don't want to be a part of it, right? And that's fine because, you know, listen, I am the enemy at this point, right? Many of them have disassociated with me, and that's cool, whatever. But I will never stop seeking and saying common sense. And if they would like to hide, then that's fine. But I do not anticipate any of them coming on anytime soon. With that said, I wish them nothing but the best. And I'm sure they do the exact same for me. 11 Bravo Gamer says, would this include old Screw Attack, old school archive Screw Attack content like Evil Craig and the original side scrollers content? Yes. Yes, it would. Tailspin says, Death Battle Discord sadly agrees with Reddit. Like I said, I don't care about that. I really don't care. Captain Zackbeard says, had a coworker of mine laugh so hard at the top 10 ghost video, he was crying. Want to do what I can to bring those back. Thanks, Captain Zackbeard. Appreciate that. Kyle says, Craig, finish the story. Thanks, Kyle. Winterfell came in and says, the Powerball is $1.1 billion. If I win, I'll buy Screw Attack for you. Ah, thanks, Winterfell. Appreciate that. It's not buying it for me. It's buying it for us. Hey, my boy Devon. Let's go. Devon, good to see you. He says, hail my other N-word, Craig. Let's go, Vagabondo. It would be cool to get Screw Attack collector's DVDs or VHS box set, if possible, as a tie-in for a crowdfund. Yeah, you know, I have thought about that. Have definitely thought about that. If a crowdfund was to happen, like I said, it would need to happen very quick. But like I said, doing a crowdfund is a lot, and I'm not afraid of the work at all. But there are other projects that I'd like to do down the line, and I don't necessarily. I'm on the fence. I mean, if I want this to be like the big ask, right? So. Bob came back and says, as a game store owner, I've started mentioning take games back to customers. Have you considered reaching out to game store owners to build up? Yes, but before I do, I have more news coming on that. But thank you, Bob. Appreciate that. Elsie Barrett says, never saw Screw Attack. Found you through G&G. Everyone always talks about it, and it makes me want to see it. Thanks, Elsie. Appreciate that. And Death Proof says, Screw Attack is already on YouTube in playlist. Cool. News to me. News to me. The fake 8-bit Mickey came in, says, what's stopping quote unquote someone from just dumping this archive of the Screw Attack videos? You showed a video from the vault without having to pay. What exactly is the need to buy it? Yeah. So, you know, that's a great question. And the need to buy it is, a lawsuit. That's really it. Doing it the right way, doing it legally, and, making sure it's done right. You know, as far as showing the vault and stuff, I feel like I'm adding commentary to it. And an example like this, I didn't necessarily add a whole lot of commentary to it. So if they want to come after me with this, then by all means, they can. But anytime I've shown any sort of Screw Attack content, I've always added my unique perspective to it, having been there for most of it. And been it's been, quote unquote, transformed. So, yes. And John says, if you have the video, you should show top 10 video game theme songs. That was my favorite video of Screw Attack, just seeing your team arguing, which is the best theme. Right. The thing about that is and that's the other thing, right? There is so much copyrighted music and material in those old Screw Attack videos that today could not be seen. And that's a great example, right? You're talking about music that is being used, and it was a lot, man. It was a lot. So that's kind of where we're at. You know, I know a lot of people have a lot of thoughts on this, and I appreciate your input on this. Like I said, we're talking about this is a major investment, and a major investment that will need to come together very quick. And I'm really on the fence about it. I hate doing polls like this because you're talking about people's money, right? And it's so, here's a lesson I learned very early on with Screw Attack. We did a poll very early on. Hey, if we had merchandise, would you like to buy it, right? 98% of people were like, hell yes, we'd like to buy it. So we went out and spent like $1,000 on merchandise because, you know, it cost a lot of money to print and hold and ship and all that stuff. We made it available and we sold two because it's always easier to click a thing than it is to actually help. Peter says, we're saying do it. We're saying do it. And the last gauge, he was like, don't do it. Do it. Don't do it. And this is also Tony Kenzen says, I miss SGC. To be clear, SGC is included in this. So we're talking Screw Attack, SGC, the Screw Attack Gaming Convention. Now, if I was to ever do Screw Attack again, like that's another huge initiative, right? So like I said, there's a lot of moving parts to this, man. There's a lot of moving parts. So Big Top came in. Says, hey, yo, hope this helps. Thanks, Big Top. Appreciate that, man. And John came in with 10 gifted memberships. That's spectacular, John. Your support is massive today. It's kind of where it's at. I think that I'm going to take the weekend and really think about this, you know, and people are right, right? Like, just focus on side-scrollers. And that's, you know, in addition to side scrollers, you know, we got Take Games Back. I mentioned Blue Bonnet a little bit ago. There's a lot. There's a lot that I have, and I want to make sure that I have the proper focus for me and for you and for the respect of all the content that was the decades worth of stuff that was there before. Yeah, man, that's crazy. Heretic says, as an OG G1, Screw Attack was my early 20s onward. First SGC made me get a passport sorted out in my first time leaving the UK on a holiday. Still have friends from the community I'm in touch with today. Screw Attack means the world to me and many others. I donate / merch. Thank you, Heretic. Appreciate that. Mr. E says Screw Attack is a dead brand. Waste of money for you to purchase it again. Right. And these are all like valid things, man. Very valid things. Like it is a brand that is and I said this earlier, like I have turned the page in my career. Like Screw Attack was an awesome part of my life. And everything that I've done up to this point, whether it's Screw Attack, Game Attack, Collaborator Club, working for Prairie Fire and everything else that happened in between there, you are an amalgamation of everything that happens before you. So I love Screw Attack. I love The Bolt. I love everything about those old videos. But for me, it's making it available again and bringing back that that culture that is very clearly gone in the space right now. So, it's kind of where it's at. Jerry Crow says, go get it, Craig. Certainly Upstrike says, as much as I would love to help you get Screw Attack back, I would rather the money go towards building up what you're building now. I would donate to help. Thanks, Certainly Upstrike. Appreciate that. And like those are like totally valid. Totally valid. Iceman says, Sputtering Craig said he wants to buy it. Good. Go get it. Go buy it. Go buy it. Like if somebody else buys it, I then it is what it is. You know, I go crazy, you know. You know, whatever. You're not going to like hurt me, you know. You're only hurting yourself. So yeah. Tweetone says, I agree. ScrewAttack had its time. Why waste six figures on something you won't relaunch? Side Scrollers is actually growing and becoming relevant to many. I'd argue it's far more successful. That's a far more successful for today. I agree. But it, like I said, it is worth discussing. Drac, my goodness, came in with a $100 super chat. Says, Craig, I love ScrewAttack, but I don't see an archive as a necessity. The community that ScrewAttack created is more what gamers need. Bringing back a community of creators that want to help one grow another, creators that want to help one another grow is what Take Games Back needs to be. That is what I'd support. That's awesome. That's awesome, Drac. That is great. And I think that's like really powerful. That's a really fucking powerful statement, right? Like the content was one thing. The videos were one thing, and we'll have those memories, but the community and the lasting effect of that is what really made the difference. And that's powerful, Drac. Thank you very much for that. That's a wonderful statement, man. And I appreciate that greatly. Andrew says, build towards the future, Craig. Thank you, Andrew. Appreciate that. All right. Let's go and watch. I do have one more video. Like I said, if I was to explore this realistically, I would look at the only new content that I would release would be like Video Game Vault's top 10s, right? So I thought it'd be fun to watch another top 10 before we go. So here's the top 10, and I'll stop, and I will transform this content, if you will. A quick reminder, this is like the actual size of the video, and I'm going to full screen it. Wonderful 480p here. Starscream says, let's say you don't buy it back. Right now, you've got the opportunity. Once that opportunity passes, would you regret it down the road? Starscream, that's a ridiculously great question. I can't speak for my future self. The one thing that I would regret by not owning it and not making that archive available, I think the one thing that I would regret is not making it publicly available for my kids. But I don't know yet. I don't know. So, Mercenary says, community is important, but we need the history. Or what are we going to gain? True. Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and continue on. Oh, I Have No Son says, if it is about just Craig, then you should recreate that content so it is just Craig. If those people in the content no longer officially terms of Craig, it would just be a bad reminder. No. But everything is going up. No. Everything would go up. But yeah, and like I said, I wouldn't be looking to build anything, but here, let's go watch this. This is the top 10. Oh, this is the top 10 Super Nintendo games, the second half of the top 20 that I did back in the day. So here we go.
Warning, the following list contains some of the best games of all.
Okay, real quick. All of you on the internet, watching on Reddit, watching on whatever, watch this intro and tell me how much I've changed.
Warning, the following list contains some of the best games of all time. If your favorite is not on the list or not where you want it to be, don't be a bitch and freak out. The Super Nintendo was just that good of a system. Hey, I'm Stuttering Craig. For ScrewAttack's top 20 Super NES games, 10 through 1.
And with that, I'd like to add this. Thanks, Bill.
Fuck off, you oversensitive little shit.
Let's continue.
10. What do you get when you take a desolate land spattered with evil demons and combine them with a little naked angel friend? Act Razor. While developing a city for your people to live in is incredibly satisfying, you've also got the kicker of romping through monsters to some of the best tunes in video game history. Oh, man, just listen to this makes you want to rip somebody's head off. Oh yeah, video game soundtrack aggression.
Number 9.
What did that say? Hold on, what did that say? Screwtech does not believe in video games cause aggression. It's misspelling, by the way. Fat chicks do. Yes, tell me how much I've changed, please. Oh my god.
Number 9.
Cute, cuddly, and unique, Yoshi's Island took shooting eggs at your ass and made it incredibly fun. Oh, whining baby Mario, you're so adorable. While the cuteness of the game may have turned some gamers off, they missed out on sublime controls and gameplay. Oh, baby Mario, now you're starting to annoy me. But this boss battle, absolutely epic. Taking on a giant baby Bowser from a few miles away while the sky is falling and he rushes you? Wow. I hate you, shut up!
Number 8.
It's pretty awesome. I know the next game immediately just based off the two tones that came out of there. Reese says, no shame in reaching out to former ScrewAttack members and collaborators. I'm sure James and other creators would be happy to get the word out. Yeah, possibly. I don't know. Shaker Maker says, you buy ScrewAttack back, make new content, but record the videos with your old cameras from the 2000s and upload it only in 240p. Let's go! I love that. Love that idea. Denny says, if it's a dead brand, not worth anything, then no one else will buy it. Wait for the price to drop. Curtis says, if you don't buy it, and if you do buy it and re-upload everything, don't be surprised if certain people demand some stuff to be taken down due to disavowing you. Just a heads up. Fuck them. I mean that sincerely.
Well, pretty much every existing NES franchise that made the jump to the Super Nintendo received a huge facelift. For our money, Mega Man made the biggest jump. Moving away from destroying robot men and focusing on kicking robot animal ass, Mega Man X brought forth a plethora of new abilities never before seen in the series, including the ability to bust a cap with a fireball straight out of Street Fighter 2. Making that jump and killing yourself off just to get it? The things we do for the little extras.
Number 7.
Hey, if you thought Super Mario 3 was impressive, this made you blow your load.
This made you blow your load. Daddy, what's that mean? Nothing, honey.
Rarely does a commercial actually sum up a game, but this one actually does.
Introducing the next generation from Nintendo, New Super Mario World, created especially for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System.
That is a great commercial. It's
a bit more exciting, a bit more challenging, a bit more compact, a bit more colorful, a bit more realistic, a bit more levels, a bit more secrets, a bit more enemies, a bit more friends, a bit more sound, a bit hotter, a bit cooler, a bit weird, a bit more revolutionary, a bit more Mario.
That is great. Good lord.
It's 16-bit, and it's yours only if you get New Super Nintendo. Now you're playing with power, superpower.
Number 6.
Josh, the brand new member. Thanks, Josh, man. You've been huge. Get those gifted memberships and the massive super chat. And Agamemnon Fireman came in and says, I genuinely miss the access to the full archive of older ScrewAttack videos. And remember the times when ScrewAttack was dominating the internet. But I also want to see you rebuild towards the future, Craig. It hasn't been the same without you. Go get it. Thanks, brother. Appreciate you, man. And yeah, that's kind of the, to be clear, I am 100% focused on the future, right? But there's this opportunity to grab the past at a time, you know? And that's a pretty unique opportunity that doesn't happen every day. St. G says, you could still make top 10s video game vaults, but with a different name if you don't own ScrewAttack. That's true, but I don't think I necessarily want to. Like I said, I want to devote my time to the other things that I have going on right now. You know, between side scrollers, Take Games Back, and Blue Bonnet, like I talked about, as well as other projects that are going on behind the scenes.
Let's take a magical journey. A journey of a boy, a girl, and a sprite.
You can't say that, sorry.
A journey where not only you could play, but so could your friends. That's right, multiplayer. In an RPG? Heck yes! Taking a different approach than traditional turn-based RPGs, Secret of Mana used an unconventional ring system for ease, which, depending on your style, you either loved or you hated it. We loved it. The only drawback to Secret of...
And by we, I mean everybody else who we talk to, except for me.
...Mana is that if you want to pick it up nowadays, it's going to cost you upwards towards 70 $5.
You know, and Invader is right. He says, with all this talk about media preservation, especially the video game space, it's worth considering this. Right. I mean, yeah. You know, we spend all this time talking about like video games being preserved. Like we have an opportunity to do this right now with videos, like thousands of videos.
Five.
A totally different change of pace to the Mario series, Super Mario RPG introduced a number of different characters to the fray that we never heard from again. Mario had moved away from jumping on Goomba's heads to now attacking, waiting patiently, hoping you don't die, scrolling through your attack options, thinking about what you want to do, and then attacking again. And
real quick, and Ice Cold says the PC police would like to erase this content for sure, right? And that's like honestly kind of why I want to bring it back. Like, I don't think anything we're saying is really that bad. But today, oh my God. Just shut up.
People loved it almost as much as G4 loves to air old episodes of Cops.
Number four.
Another RPG? Using its massive 32 megs of power, Chrono Trigger made gamers say wow the first time they popped it in their Super Nintendo.
Thanks, crazy people.
Let's talk about the awesome points. Innovative fighting system, check. Multiple endings, check. Time travel, check.
It's so weird, because like, I don't know if y'all remember these, but I remember making these videos and like these little touches of the guy going, yeah, like these things just hit me in my feels, you know?
Busting out crazy-ass double and triple techs, you bet your ass. When was the last time you saw a giant frog crush a minion? Hell, they even had a little cameo from a game that may or may not be in the list later on. And the Power Glove. Will we ever see another game in the Chrono series? Unfortunately, it looks like the Chronobus has made its last stop.
Number three.
You are correct, Clinton.
I remember the first time I rented Final Fantasy 3 or 6 and realized, what the hell? I can't beat this game in 3 days and I'm gonna have to rent it again. Shit. Final Fantasy 3 is a...
Now, I'm gonna tell you this right now. Like, these lists are still good. Like, maybe not the order of the list, but the production of these videos are still... They still hold up, man. Just watching this. I mean, that's good stuff. The music is good. The draws you in with the tunes. It's really good stuff, man. I mean, not to toot our, you know, toot the old horn or anything, but I think they're still pretty solid.
Hallmark on the Super Nintendo. Multiple plot lines, one of the most badass mofos in video game history, and of course, the opera scene. While Final Fantasy V was remarkable, Final Fantasy VI took everything to a new level. Some argue that this soundtrack is the best in the Final Fantasy series. That is a statement.
Number two.
Now here is an upgrade for you. A Link to the Past. This is the first time we're actually introduced to a major Zelda storyline. Link fought in both the light and dark worlds in an attempt to foil Ganon's evil plans with the Triforce. Also included for the first time is what might be the most useful weapon in Zelda history, the hookshot. Why use a boomerang when you can just stab a guy from the other side of the screen? Also, don't forget about that badass fairy who upgrades your Master Sword. Your sword is stronger. You can feel it throbbing in your hand. That's sexual.
And then the countdown. We got our countdown from 10 to 2 before we get to number one. Yeah, these are like, I'm not saying all the top 10s are good because they weren't. But these are pretty good. This one's pretty good.
If you missed the first half of the Super Nintendo Top 20, hey, there's still time. Go back and watch it. But in the meantime, let's recap the top 10 before we get to number 1. Number 10, ActRaiser. Number 9, Yoshi's Island. Number 8, Mega Man X. Number 7, Super Mario World. Number 6, Secret of Mana. Number 5, Super Mario RPG. Number 4, Chrono Trigger. Number 3, Final Fantasy VI. And number 2, Zelda, A Link to the Past.
It's number 1.
Let's go. You know this one. Hobocop says, take influences from the past and help and let it help your future. Imagine new lineup and maybe familiar faces. A new era with the same attitude equals gold. That's really nice. And thank you, Hobocop. Like I said, I don't really have a whole lot of interest in building out a new team. You know, I'm focused on side scrollers moving ahead. And I think it's what's needed now. Leafy says Screw Attack can work today. Some shows just need tweaking for modern taste. Oh, we're gonna modern audience. Screw Attack. Fuck that. People prefer longer YouTube videos nowadays, but the jokes still work. I'm gonna bring back Screw Attack for modern audiences. All right, here we go. Here's number one.
It's number one.
The last Metroid is in captivity. The galaxy is at peace.
The largest game available at the time at a heaping 24 megs, Super Metroid is the best 2D action adventurer ever, let alone on the Super Nintendo. From the opening sequence, you knew that you were in for one thing. Greatness. A game that is 100% complete from beginning to end. There's only one word to describe how you feel after playing Super Metroid. Satisfied. Whether it was the throwback to the old Metroid levels at the beginning of the game, or going out of your way to save your little buddies at the end to see if Little Pixel escaped the exploding planet, Super Metroid left nothing. Nothing. Not done. Super Metroid, like any of the games on this list, could easily be considered the best game of all time.
Let's go. It's pretty good. Not bad. Not bad. You guys have been awesome today. And now Neznik says, seeing Chrono Trigger reminded me that today would have been Akira Toriyama's 69th birthday. Man. Delta came in with the five. Says, hey, Craig, missed a few days since Dev and you talked to John. But did you guys cover Ross and his plan to go after Ubisoft and the other developers shutting down their games and harming physical ownership? Might be able to interview him. Yeah, Delta, actually, we talked about it briefly today for probably 5-10 minutes. I definitely suggest going back and watching it. Avisal says, yes, working towards the future is a must. We must also not forget the past. Screw Attack is a past that we do not need to be forgotten or get lost, especially nowadays with things being replaced or old things getting changed. You guys are like, I'm telling you, I'm going back and forth. I'm like, yeah. Then I'm like, duh. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I am in a glass case of emotions today, guys. That's where I'm at. So let's close with this. We've been sitting here chatting for about an hour talking about this. Let me give you the TLDR real quick. I have an opportunity to buy back Screw Attack. The asking price is into the six figures. It is not financially feasible to buy a dead brand at six figures. I have no intention of rebooting this brand with a new group or anything like that moving ahead. The only content that I would consider making is video game vaults and or top tens to accent the content that would be going up as part of an archive for Screw Attack. The entire idea of the archive would simply be to let the content be available. The content itself would be released in its original format, 240p, 480p, 1080p, whatever the original video was released in, that is what it would be uploaded in. There would be no upscaling. The idea is that we are creating a vault, if you will, a vault of the content that has been more or less removed from the official sources on YouTube. And that is the idea is, let's make it all in one place. Let's make an official outlet for it and an official place where people can go. Com says, have you confirmed that they have the original videos? Make sure the archive is complete. I would say, Com, thank you for that. I have most of the videos already. And that's the other thing about this is I have access to most of them. I don't know what they have and what they don't have, but the vast majority of it I already have. So, that's kind of the other thing. John says, found a channel on YouTube with Video Game Vault, which has almost 600 videos on it. Yeah, right. I know, I hear you. But I think the idea is that can be taken down at any time. And I don't want that to happen again. You know, I don't want that to happen again. So, Will Into the Life with Brian. Kevin says, don't you say to us, if you have a goal, go get it. This is your goal. Well, Brian, yes, I do every day. But to be clear, this is not like my goal. Right. Like my goal was to build an amazing company and grow it. And well, initially it wasn't to sell it, but we eventually did sell it. Right. But my goal was to go and enjoy work every day and go and build something that lasts. And I think Screw Attack has done that. And I think Side Scrollers is doing that now. So with that, I feel like I'm accomplishing goals. This is a goal, but not the goal, right? And several of you have said like it's important to build towards the future while also, you know, having access to the past. And I think that's right. You know, there have been several really good comments about this and given me a lot to think about. And Ex Mortis says, is there no possibility of negotiating a lower price? Once again, I think that when it comes to negotiating, you're dealing with a company, Time Warner Discovery, that probably didn't even know that they owned Screw Attack, right? It was just this thing. It was this thing that was maybe a line item several years ago that's not even on the list of line items now. This is a speck of sand in a vast beach of properties and things that company owns. It's not even thought about on a day-to-day basis. So for them to even like consider something, like we're talking about a multi-billion dollar company. So even a six-figure asking price is nothing for them. But like I said, it is kind of worth discussing. So Intact Gaming came in with the $4.99. Thank you very much. That's awesome. And Backyard Tardis says, Craig, let the G2s decide. Put it up on Kickstarter. If it reaches the goal, then it's meant to be. If not, if it doesn't, then it's not. Yeah, I mean, that's very true. That's very true. I have no problem with failing with this at all. I have no problem failing at all. And you're probably right. Ultimately, you guys will decide. I have no problem contributing, you know, five figures to this to make it happen. You know, I wouldn't expect you guys to fund this by yourselves. Because, you know, like I said, I want it back too. But I am very much looking forward to, you know, the idea of potentially owning it. You are Screw Attack, Craig. Where you are, Screw Attack is. Thanks, brother. Appreciate that, man. Sean says, reacquiring Screw Attack is less of a goal and more of an opportunity to retake legacy and history. Thank you, Sean. Appreciate that. All right. I think that's where we're going to be. That's kind of where we're going to go. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to think about this over the weekend. And if I decide to move forward with some sort of crowdfunding thing, I will let you know early next week, Monday or probably Tuesday. And then we'll move forward. So I you know, you guys give me a lot to think about, and this is exactly what I'd hope it would be, is a lot of feedback from you guys. If you guys are watching the archive, please head down in the comments. Let me know what you guys think of this. I'm going to leave this video up so people can watch and react and provide their feedback as well. It says, talk to your wife about this. Right. Of course. I have talked to my wife about this plenty. So, all right, guys, have an excellent weekend. I'll see you guys later on. We'll have another video going up on the channel in a little bit, a nice clip from the day. It's funny to say, consolidate the brand, Screw Attack and Screw Attack Side Scrollers. I think they would be standalone for sure. Have a great weekend, guys. I'll see you guys later. I'll have more on this early next week. Until then, guys, remember, people are going to try to keep you down. Don't let them. You guys got a goal. Go get it. See you guys later. Bye-bye.